list, but they're short, are based on one of the Holy Week Passion tunes that we know the best. Most modern hymnals name this tune Passion Chorale. Chorale, of course, is the German word for hymn. This is a wonderful example of the constant interplay between sacred and secular that has existed in the music of the church and the world, the Western world, throughout many centuries. The original melody was a secular song by Mr. Hassler, whose name you see. And I'm going to play it first because it's in a wonderful dance-like rhythm. Somewhere along the way in the 17th century, as the German churches began to get rid of their light, airy, frilly altarpieces and put in much more severe, heavy altar work, the hymns got squared up and put into a more even rhythm. So I'm going to begin by playing you two versions of this hymn. The first is the original song by Hassler, and then I'll play one harmonization by by Johann Sebastian Bach from his Matthew Passion, just to show you a rich harmony. And then I will begin the pieces. The first, by Kuhnau, is, well, I should say that for the most part, you get a real rich panoply of the German organ world and church world in the 17th century. And all of these composers were distinguished. They were wonderful composers, they were wonderful organists, they were wonderful church musicians in the major towns of Germany. At the end, I'll throw in a few later things. Reger is a much later German composer, and a couple of French treatments as well. The beginning, Kuhnau, was Bach's predecessor at the big churches of Leipzig, where Bach spent the last 25 or so years of his life, the major part of his career. Then we'll see a variety of other composers, and I'll talk a bit more about some of them along the way. Thank you. This is a meditation, so I'm not eager to hear you applaud, but rather to have you be in prayer with me as we encounter the wonderful witness of these composers. People ask me sometimes, what do you say to a non-believer about your faith? And I always say that one of the things I will always say is the evidence of the arts, music and the visual arts, and even dance in response to the Christian faith is evidence enough for me. Thank you.
Thank you.
So in case you lost your place, that was the one by Mr. Kellner, slightly younger than the great Bach. So we saw from the early end of the 17th century, Kuhnau, Bach's predecessor, Buxtehude, one of Bach's mentors, Pachelbel, one generation older contemporary, Kaufmann, an exact contemporary who in fact did not get the position at Leipzig when Bach got it, Telemann, another contemporary of Bach, much more famous in his time since he was the court composer. And then the piece you heard of Bach, not the very last one, but the one before that, was a youthful piece which was only discovered about 35 years ago. Hidden away in with a whole bunch of youthful pieces, the existence of which was known, but the whereabouts of the actual copies was not known until they were discovered by a Harvard musician in the Yale Library in the 1980s. So now we'll switch times a little bit. The last pieces that Johannes Brahms wrote in his life were a dozen or so organ preludes on hymns about this life and the next, and some other things. But he wrote two settings of this on this melody, and you'll hear them both. Max Reger, very short setting, chromatically rich and intense, as you can imagine if you know any of his music or the music of the late very late 1800s. Then two glimpses into France, and French organists have always revered Bach and have claimed him as their own. When I studied in France, organ recitals rarely had printed programs, so they were announced. And any piece of Bach that was going to be performed was always described as something by Notre Jean-Sébastien, our Jean-Sébastien. So Lenglet, one of the great Parisian organists of the 20th century, and Dupré, a generation ahead of him, master teacher, master performer, master composer. Very short setting of Dupré, it's a teaching piece, but eloquent in its economy. Then I'll finish with a classic, simple, eloquent setting by the great Bach. Thank you.